Hello for Monday, May 16th, and there's no market charts in this video because they're all in the newsletter, so please check with them there. What happened on Friday? We had a market pullback, but we had some stocks that moved up further. You know I like the name Iridium, and you can check them if you're interested in holding this one. Now it's the second day, actually it triggered the day before, but then it pulled back, so we left it on the list. It's triggered at the same point again. It moved up nicely, almost up to this area to fill this gap, 874, got to 872. Volume was pretty good, about average. But if you're interested, you know, maybe you could read some news on the company. Maybe they've turned a corner and can start moving up, maybe not. But I know there was some news, and you can see here we had some indications of buy on the Williams and so forth. But if you're interested longer term, then watch that. We are above the top Bollinger Band a bit, but you can notice in the past they've done that before, creeped up it, and even shot over it. So we'll see how that goes. Selling part and keeping part is always a good idea. And AAP had a good move up today. You can see it triggered a bit the day before, and then this is the day that it's shown with nice volume, and nice volume recently before that as well. So that was a nice move. And IMAX, this is we don't have a lot of these setups, unfortunately, as many, but IMAX, you know, has been on the move quite a while, with them opening more screens, and it's taken how many years? Forever. It's a long, long time. And I wish they'd make more 3D films and make them actually in full-length features, but I guess it's too difficult. Anyway, we like these because when they break out, the chances of them, if they have good volume, and this did over 400% volume, it doesn't look it, but lately the volume's been so low, that's why it's down here, it doesn't look that way. But quite often, if you have good volume, the first target can be at the horizontal breakout line. And so even if they can't break out quite often, you'll get that. And that's why we like this setup, and we like this one anyway, because we like the company and so forth. But even if you bought it at the horizontal, it still did 66 cents. So that was a good play. So now we've got additions to the watch list. They're all longs. The market, I know, is pulling back. But look how many stocks keep on trying to move higher. And a lot of shorts that we look at, it's hit or miss as far as some of them dip and then bounce right back up. You know, someone was, if they were short APL here, they'd look good, it'd drop below the 50, and then the next day it gaps up and runs up on big volume. So Atlas Pipeline Partners, 37.35, looks like the area, this is where we have the line drawn here, and then 37.90 over that, but 37.35 looks like a play on that. And ATLS, in this case, this 25.25 looks like a play because of the increased volume. If it just done that, it's hitting again the same resistance and it might fall right back. But the bigger volume suggests it's going to try again, and if it breaks through there, it could easily it could go back up at least that 27 area. AMLN, there we are. You know, we like this sector a lot. We've had a lot of good results with the pharmaceutical biotech. And it had a problem in March, and it gapped down, and it's been moving up a little bit, increase in volume. Don't know if it can get into this gap and fill it or not, but 1385 was a recent high over there. So I think if it can break that, we may be able to at least go up to the 1459 200 day and maybe even fill the gap. It all depends on volume. When you see good volume coming in, that's a good indication it's going to give at least a good try. If it's lighter volume and you want to take a position, you always take just a lighter position. HS over 4420 or 4450 would be up here. It was 4447, but the first theory part would be 4420. Also had increased volume on a down market day, so we like that. Then if we have a good market day, maybe they'll go up. And this one's, you know, these are always risk plays down here because they gap down and it's been not very long. So why would they go back up? They'd go back up because people felt the gap was too much for it. Anyway, if you like this sort of thing, it may be one that doesn't trigger right away. But It looks like about 1991 is that little area, and we looked and the historical information, and that's 2025 is that top line. So if you're interested, there you have that one. How about CCE over $29.20? That was its high of the day. Depending on how it trades the next couple of days, maybe you'll get in at 29 even again on a move, but over that if it backs off a little and then comes in with good volume. NVLS is another. 3760 would be one area, and that's just about where we have this line drawn, as you can see. But it did run up as far as 3840. So if you like, you could wait to that. I think that this 3760, again, if it doesn't happen like the first moments of the morning, if it builds up to it, I think that might be the trade, because then it might just be testing the next high, and that would already be a good trade in itself. So, but if then it can break through that, long black candle on the left could run it up to 40. MSPD over about $9.23. It pulled back. We'd watch this for a couple days or one day. So the pullback, so we think now is the time we'll add it and see how it does. It might pull back another day, but it had increased volume on this move up, so maybe it will continue as well. And also RCII over $32.26, another gap situation. It went over the 20-day, but then it pulled back, but the volume was lighter. That's why it may just try again. If not, we'll take it off the list. So that's what we have to start off the week with. I hope you have a good spring week ahead, good trading and so forth. Pay attention to our tweets. And also, we'll be back again tomorrow with a new additions video. So thanks a lot. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.